Next, we discuss about different classes of immunoglobulin. So there are 5 classes of immunoglobulin. They are immunoglobulin G, immunoglobulin A, immunoglobulin M, immunoglobulin E, and immunoglobulin D. So first we discuss immunoglobulin G. The immunoglobulin G which contain gamma heavy chains. So the immunoglobulin G contains gamma heavy chain, and it is also known as warm immunoglobulin. Then the half-life of immunoglobulin G is 23 days. And almost immunoglobulin is immunoglobulin G. That means the 80% of total immunoglobulin which contain immunoglobulin G. So it's considered as a major serum immunoglobulin. And the immunoglobulin G is again divided into 4 subclasses. They are immunoglobulin G1, immunoglobulin G2, immunoglobulin G3, and immunoglobulin G4. And the 65% of immunoglobulin G is immunoglobulin G1. And 23% of immunoglobulin G is immunoglobulin G2, and 8% of immunoglobulin G is immunoglobulin G3, and 4% of immunoglobulin G is immunoglobulin G4. And the size of immunoglobulin G is very small, so it's a very small sized immunoglobulin, but it's the major immunoglobulin. Their amount is very higher, but the size is very small. And it's only immunoglobulin G or the immunoglobulin G is the only maternal immunoglobulin that cross the placenta, and it's providing immunity to newborn babies. So it's considered as a, or immunoglobulin G is considered as a maternal immunoglobulin, and it's secreted in milk. So that's about the immunoglobulin G. So the immunoglobulin G which contain gamma heavy chains, it also known as warm immunoglobulin, and the half-life of immunoglobulin G is 23%, and it's considered as a major immunoglobulin because the 80% of total immunoglobulin which contains immunoglobulin G. And the immunoglobulin G is again subdivided into 4 subclasses. They are immunoglobulin G1, G2, G3, and G4, and it's small in size, and it's considered as the only immunoglobulin, or it's the only maternal immunoglobulin which cross the placenta and providing immunity into newborn babies, and it's also secreted in milk. Then the second type is immunoglobulin A. The immunoglobulin A which contain alpha heavy chains. So the immunoglobulin A contains alpha heavy chains, and the half-life of immunoglobulin A is 6 days, and it occur in 2 forms. They are serum form and secretory forms, and it's considered as a second abundant class of immunoglobulin. So after the immunoglobulin G, immunoglobulin A is considered as second abundant class of immunoglobulin. So it's contained 10-30% of total immunoglobulin, and it also secreted in milk. So that's about the immunoglobulin A. So immunoglobulin A is contained alpha heavy chains, and the half-life of immunoglobulin A is 6 days, and it occur in 2 forms, serum form and secretory form, and it considered as a second abundant class of immunoglobulin. That means 10-13% of total immunoglobulin is immunoglobulin A. It also secreted in milk. Then third type is immunoglobulin M. The immunoglobulin M which contain mu heavy chains, and it's considered as a largest sized immunoglobulin. It's a large sized immunoglobulin present in blood serum. So immunoglobulin M is considered as, it's a largest sized immunoglobulin, and 5-8% of total immunoglobulin which contains immunoglobulin M, and it's also called as cold immunoglobulin, and it's considered as a earliest immunoglobulin synthesized by fetus. So in the fetus condition, it is the first synthesized or early synthesized immunoglobulin, and the half-life of immunoglobulin M is 5 days. And it's mainly responsible for type 2 hypersensitivity. Okay, that's about the immunoglobulin M. So the immunoglobulin M, which contain mu heavy chains, and it's considered as a large sized immunoglobulin, and 5 to 8% of total immunoglobulin which contain immunoglobulin M, and it also known as cold immunoglobulin, and it is the earliest immunoglobulin synthesized by fetus, and the half-life of immunoglobulin M is 5 days, and it's mainly responsible for type 2 hypersensitivity. Okay, then the fourth type is immunoglobulin E. The immunoglobulin E is mainly contain epsilon heavy chains. Immunoglobulin E is contain epsilon heavy chains, and the half-life of immunoglobulin A is 2 to 8 days. And only 1% of total immunoglobulin is immunoglobulin E. It's playing a specific role in parasitic reaction. That means the high amount of immunoglobulin E is responsible for some allergic conditions. So it's contain only least concentration in blood serum, and it's mainly responsible for type 1 hypersensitivity. So the immunoglobulin A is contain epsilon heavy chains, and the half-life of immunoglobulin A is 2 to 8 days, and the 1% of total immunoglobulin is the immunoglobulin A, and it play a specific role in pathogens reactions or parasitic reactions. The high concentration of immunoglobulin E leads to the allergic reactions. That means it's mainly responsible for type 1 hypersensitivity. That's about the immunoglobulin E. And the last type of immunoglobulin is immunoglobulin D. The immunoglobulin D is mainly contain delta heavy chains. So immunoglobulin D contain delta heavy chains, and it's structure is mainly similar to the immunoglobulin G. The structure of immunoglobulin D is more similar to the immunoglobulin G, and it serves as a recognition receptor of antigens. It activates B lymphocytes for antibody activity. That means the production of antibody or suppression of antibodies. So the immunoglobulin D, which contain delta heavy chain, and the structure of immunoglobulin D is exactly similar to the immunoglobulin G, and its main function is recognition of receptor of antigens, and it activate B lymphocytes for antibody production or suppression. These are the types of immunoglobulin, or the 5 types of immunoglobulin present in the human blood serum. Okay.